Cause I'ma take that to each and every city. Homie, I'ma take that, take that. 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 I think I need an ad lib from Diddy. Cause I'ma take that to each and every city. Homie, I'ma. The Cray sell a million records. And my name don't get mentioned in the review. It don't matter, get the W.
Otis Amey exemplifies everything that we look for in a student athlete. Bar none, is the hardest working individual I have ever been associated with. There was nobody that worked harder over a 5-year period at Sacramento State, at University of Nebraska, here at American River College, than Otis Amey. Well, ARC, welcome to Otis Amey.
Hey! Do you really want to win or just look good losing? What are you guys playing for? You guys ain't playing to win 5 in a row or win 10 in a row, right? They're playing to be the state champion, whatever it is, right? They're playing to win every single game. But it starts with focusing right now. So side means to kill off. What about homicide? Suicide. Genocide. Mass amount of people. What does decide mean? It means you choose whatever you're trying to do. Right, it could be I'm trying to go to Illinois, or I'm trying to go to Sac State or whatever. I'm trying to make my mama proud. I'm trying to make Coach Osterhout proud. Once you make that decision, you kill off every other option. But if you can play, they will find you. It doesn't matter where you go. The only reason Sac State you can gave me an offer is because, yes, they saw athletic ability, but I had a 3.6 GPA. And I had a pretty good SAT and ACT score. So the only thing that got me to Sac State was my grades. How many want to make it to the NFL? Everybody, hands go up. I want to make it. I want to make it. Okay, that's cool. How many of y'all play Madden here? Everybody, right? Is your Madden player's attributes better than yours?
Hell yeah.
All right. Whoever said that, your chance to make it ain't that great. You're spending more time developing your Madden player's attributes, working your thumbs, right? Instead of getting out on the field, practicing, going hard, and working on yourself. It's going to be hard. It's going to be extra hard to make. Everybody talks about a why, but I've never heard anybody say this. You got to test your why. I mean, you got to test your why. So you guys going out to practice 5-0, right? Coming up, why you getting ready to go to college, 6 weeks. Test your why. You can test it in the morning when you wake up. If you stay asleep after that why comes across your mind, it's not strong enough. If that why makes you hop up out of bed, it's a legitimate why. When you're at practice and you're doing conditioning or in a weight room and you want to quit, if that why comes across your mind and you tap out, it's not strong enough. I want to go to the Patriots. That's the side of me looking at it from a non-business standpoint. As you guys are going to see, the decisions you make are business. NFL is straight business. How good you are, I would say, is the third thing. What school you came from, how much money they pay you, then how good you are. It's straight. There's a lot of politics involved in it. And this is what I did. I don't know what you guys faith or belief is, but I would read my Bible first every night, and then I would read my playbook, which was about this thing. Knowing that I can't afford to mess up. So I'll do that, and I noticed things started to change. I'm going to have to make an impact somehow. When they put me in, it would be on run plays. It wouldn't even be passing plays. I'm like, they're trying to play me right now. So this is what I said. I said, I'm going to have to knock somebody out or something. Get real close to them. The last second, I get up under him. Lift him. He goes flying backwards. I'm over him like, yeah. So that night, we come to a meeting just like this. Owners, everybody. All they do is they show that play 8 to 10 times. This mother kid from Sac State, he wants to make it. Blah, blah, blah. From there, they started giving me more and more reps. I was preparing for my opportunity. It's more about life than anything else. But what I said, what I put out in the universe, happened. The very first game, the very first time I touched the ball, I scored a 75-yard punt return for a touchdown. It was on the top 10 of the ESPN countdown. It's what I said, what I spoke, right?
Decapitating dragons, we are just a vapor on paper on another vapor of a microcosm of a remnant of minions running like Kenyans, like Obama, in repentance to the father. Better warn the town, the beast is loose, and you on the same team if the dream's from the same king, if it floats from the same stream, if it don't, then it's gangrene.
Give a junkie your inch, he's taking a mile. Give a junkie a dream, he's taking him out. With the power of a catalyst, catalyst sheen through the wild. I hear him whooping with the Lion King, is keeping him down. Judas to your Judas, I'm repeating it now. I love to think the victory is keeping us.
Once you learn in football, this message transcends just football. It's about life. I learned so much from Coach Bias, Coach Osterhout, Coach Angus McClure, all my coaches that have developed me into a leader of my job. I took everything I learned from football, the dedication, the passion, the purpose, and applied it to life. If you can look at me, and I can tell you I made it, then it's fine. possible, man. That's what I did, man. And I remember, it was crazy, so I remember being in a room just like this, and the head coach walks in, and I'm like, man, this is the dude that just told me I wasn't gonna make it. And I noticed all the seats weren't full like they usually are, so I'm like, what's going on right now? And he gets up and says, everybody in this room, you guys are the 2005 San Francisco 49ers. You guys made the team. And I go to my locker, now I got a real locker. It's the real deal. And they got this jersey hanging up in there, right? When you become a man and you start having children, you have family, there's nobody I know that I can call except for me that's gonna put Pampers on my daughter's bus or pay my mortgage. It's about me. I gotta provide for my family.
Give it up, Coach Amey.